In 1939, the scientific community was coming to terms with the discovery of nuclear fission, or the splitting of an atom. Scientists believed that the process of splitting the nucleus of an atom would produce a self-sustaining series of reactions, or a chain reaction. But could such a chain reaction be produced and controlled? Enrico Fermi set out to determine just that.
Fermi's idea is to build a large pile, as he called it, of graphite bars interspersed with uranium. And he theorizes, along with his other fellow scientists, that if he gets it at the right geometry, then the neutrons that are generated will be confined into the uranium in the pile, and at the appropriate geometry, he'll get a chain reaction. And it's also very critical that there are no other impurities in the graphite or the uranium, because they can absorb neutrons.
To test his theory, Fermi built his test reactor, or pile as he called it, under the squash courts at the University of Chicago. On December 2, 1942, he was able to begin the reaction and continue it until it was self-sustaining or went critical. Even more important, Fermi could control the reaction and stop it when he wanted to.
So that basically was the background for the reactor at Hanford. A pile of graphite with the uranium in it. The difference is this one is now introducing cooling materials to essentially take away the incredible amount of heat.
Fermi's work in Chicago proved that humans could control a nuclear chain reaction. But taking the first crude nuclear reactor in Chicago and building one of the scale and complexity required at Hanford would require incredible technical expertise and ingenuity.